Greetings. Thank you, Brother Eugene, for a great question. Anyway, Christ comes from the word Christos, Greek, meaning anointed. Hebrew translated Messiah. Cyrus was also called Christ. He was a pagan. David the king also called Christ. Pots and pans also called Christ. In your Bible, where and how does the word Christ become Son of God? That's a great question, brother. If that were the question preventing you from eternal salvation in God's presence, I think it would be in your interest to study until you figured it out. So your question was, how did Messiah become or change to mean Son of God? But your question is great because it has forced me to research and dig into the issue to explain it. As you point out, the word Messiah does still mean anointed. So I do not think the meaning of the word Messiah changed. The fascinating thing, brother, is that the high priest of Israel knew this very relationship, or at least appeared to. In fact, he appeared to mix the two as the same thing when he questioned Jesus. Matthew 26:63. But Jesus remained silent. Then the high priest said to him, I charge you under oath by the living God, tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God. Mark 14:61. But he kept silent and did not answer. Again, the high priest was questioning him and saying to him, are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One? It is possible the high priest was asking two questions in one, because Jesus had called himself by both titles. The high priest may have been asking if Jesus would admit to either, because either would be grounds for further questioning, torture, and possibly sentence of death for blasphemy. Linguistically, I would expect or between two selections or alternatives. But it is also possible, and even more likely, that the high priest was associating the two as synonymous. Jesus called himself the Son of God, and Jesus identified himself as the Messiah. This is recorded in the Scriptures. John 10:36, do you say of him whom the Father sanctified and sent into the world, you are blaspheming, because I said I am the Son of God? John 4:25, the woman said, I know that Messiah, called Christ, is coming. When he comes, he will explain everything to us. Jesus answered, I who speak to you am he. I think the thing that happened is the recognition that the two titles applied to the same individual, and are therefore synonymous in that regard. And even more than that, scriptures were finally understood to reveal the unique place given to the prophesied Messiah of God. As you point out, kings were often anointed, and even called anointed, because they were appointed by Yahweh God, and not elected by men or determined by conquest. King David was identified by Prophet Samuel, for example, chosen from the sons of Jesse. 1 Samuel 16:13, then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brothers, and the Spirit of the Lord, Yahweh, rushed upon David from that day forward. And Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. Oil is different than water, brother. Oil coats. Oil leaves residue. Oil leaves a film. Water washes. Water cleans. Water removes. But even if Messiah still only meant anointed, the anointing of God is not to be compared to or confused with the washing of your head with water for daily prayers. The prophets of Yahweh God reveal many details of the Messiah, many things to find in a pursuit of the truth. As you point out, the word Christ is from the Greek word Christos, but the disciples and Jesus spoke Hebrew, where the original word used is Messiah. And while Christos and Messiah mean anointed, the concept of anointing is foreign to Muslims. It is more than simply dripping of water on or pouring of water on someone. God's anointing is often with other than water, brother. And the anointing of the Messiah is the perfect example. Acts 10:38. Jesus from Nazareth, how God anointed him with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and healing all those being oppressed by the devil, because God was with him. The power of God was poured on Jesus, or given to Jesus, and Jesus could heal as he wished, as he willed, without even needing permission. Mark 1:40, and a leper came to him, imploring him and kneeling, said to him, "If you will, you can make me clean." Moved with pity, he stretched out his hand and touched him and said to him, "I will, be clean." And immediately the leprosy left him and he was made clean. Jesus could heal as he wished, as he willed, without even needing permission. So anointing describes the process whereby something, water or the Holy Spirit of God or power or other things, is conceptually poured over to create a persistent effect. Water is used to wash or cleanse, as Muslims do in their ritual cleansing before prayers. Water removes dirt. The other elements mentioned are completely foreign to Islam's use, so they may not make sense to you. But read again about the two things that God anointed Jesus with. Jesus from Nazareth, how God anointed him with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and healing all those being oppressed by the devil, because God was with him. Islam teaches you that Jesus needed Allah's permission to heal. But clearly, Jesus did not need to ask to heal, because Jesus was anointed with power. Because Jesus was anointed with power, the power persisted. There was always a residue. The power would even flow without his intention, brother. So great was the anointing on Jesus. Luke 8:42b. As Jesus went with him, the crowds pressed around him, including a woman who had been subject to bleeding for 12 years. She had spent all her money on physicians, but no one was able to heal her. She came up behind Jesus and touched the fringe of his cloak, and immediately her bleeding stopped. "Who touched me?" Jesus asked. But they all denied it. "Master," said Peter, "the people are crowding and pressing against you." But Jesus declared, "Someone touched me, for I know that power has gone out from me." Think about that. Jesus did not know who touched him, but he knew power had left his body. But Jesus declared, "Someone touched me, for I know that power has gone out from me." Then the woman, seeing that she could not escape notice, came trembling and fell down before him. In the presence of all the people, she explained why she had touched him and how she had immediately been healed. "Daughter," said Jesus, "your faith has healed you. Go in peace." The power of God healed her, but Jesus said her faith had healed her. Jesus was anointed with power by God. Even Islam cannot deny Jesus is the Messiah, brother, and Jesus said he was the Son of God. That does not mean the definition of Messiah had changed to mean the Son of God. The Son of God just happened to be the Messiah. The question for Islam is, why ignore the rest of the message of the prophets that explains and defines who and what the Messiah is. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.